Alright, everybody, time for game number one. Let's battle. Alright, that's a really nice hand. Good power, good influence, early removal, smuggler, Vara. Kind of a dream opener. Can get the second shadow with the Seek power. So we have our Vara set up. Yeah, I don't mind having more power here, plus we need a lot of influence, so need like 1 to 2 more fire and 2 more justice. I'm not sure if I wanna suffocate this. I should not have played the justice here. That was bad making this a 3-4. Guess we have to suffocate it and hope the opponent doesn't have a teacher next turn, or if they have a teacher that they don't have a choice. At least we're gonna be able to go to the market before that happens. So it's not that bad. Alright, nothing bad happened. That's great. Okay, I think we want to play this here. The interesting question is, what do we get rid of? Actually, kind of tough. I quite like plate here, like I mentioned. Problem is, getting Harshul here is probably bad because of Stand Together. It's just unnecessarily risky. Sure, we have Vara, but if our Vara sticks around, Harshuling also seems bad. Pristine Light is okay, but it's not that good against that deck. Like right now, the opponent has one target, but they don't have that many. So Plate is probably it. Question is, if we get Plate, do we just put away the Hidden Road Smuggler? I don't hate that, actually. With the double Vara draw, Vara is really, really good against Combre. I think that's what we're gonna do, actually. Because we need the power for the Plate and the influence. And here we can just trade, force him to have something. Which makes our Vara more safe. That's the thing, like, Deepforge Blade is secretly the best market card against Combre aggro. Because Vanquish, like, Pristine Light is narrow, Harshul is clunky and gets blown out by Stand Together. And, like, Knife is a good second market card, but not a good first. And Tomb is not for the matchup. That's okay, like, see here we just baited a stand on one unit. That's pretty solid outcome. And now we have a Vara. The opponent's not gonna be happy. I think I'm gonna trade, I'm not sure. I think I don't. Like, there's not a whole lot the opponent can do, and like I said, if they play something here, we're looking pretty good. Interesting. Don't think we want to play it here. Too risky. Oh, okay. Opponent doesn't have anything. I like it. Which means I actually just play it here because that gives us a good turn here. Seems weird to play it post-combat, but it's pretty good here. Gives us a 10-10 blocker, and it's the safest line against the teacher that also sequences well next turn. Basically. Attack. Should have played the Vara first, in case he wants to sec. Alright. Good game. See, this is what I mean, play it is just complete destruction in this matchup. So is Vara. Like, that's your game plan here. Just Vara and Blade. That's the thing, combat tricks are not removal and combat tricks are really bad against Vara. Let's read. Yeah, we can just attack with bows. Even if he has a choice now, it's fine. We can just replay a 5-5. Otherwise he has to trade and goes to 1. He has the choice. It's fine. And we don't even need to block, like, if the opponent attacks here, we get to draw a card that's actually kind of good. We can even still play the Rizan. We draw it for 8. Yep. And we are on the offense, like, attacking here is actually bad for the opponent. Like, he's not the aggro deck anymore. Mind over body. And he is dead now. Display lethal. Or Rizan lethal, or whatever really we want. Easy game, easy life. Oh, 12 ranks, sweet. Yep, yep, yep. And that's why Blade is so good, despite it looking kind of random. Because in a lot of... Like, the thing is, in the theory ideal scenarios, Blade is not great and not even needed. But the thing is, the reality is much more messy and dynamic than the theory. And in reality, in a lot of situations, Blade is suddenly your best card, either because the opponent can't deal with it, or because the opponent can deal with your other, like, ideal plans pretty well, but not that well with the Blade, and the Blade gives you a similarly powerful line that still allows you to win, but circumvents what your opponent is trying to do, or what the opponent expects you to do or is trying to do to you, to what you are doing to do. That was a bit complicated, but I think you get the idea. Anyway, that was a really nice depiction of why Blade is good and should not be cut. And it's probably even better than Pristine Light in the market. So if you want to find room for Gavel, it probably has to be Pristine Light, which is something that I'm also not super happy about. All right, that's it for game 1. See you in a moment with game number 2.